suck of a hole.
The Bunchbuckers will live forever!
Incoming! Above you!
sucker the ball.
The Bunchbuckers will live forever!
I call it.
A visit and give him more of the same.
We have seen this before. Revenge will not bring you peace.
Is it revenge if justice is served?
That is a question you must answer for yourself.
Appreciate it.
Oh, your enemies are gonna be in lots of pieces. Wanna talk for a spell?
Thank you.
to Vanaheim's crater.
There's work to be done. Bound to be even more dangerous beasties with valuable resources.
I'm with you.
A stag of winter. It looks hungry.
Come on already! Just come back with me. I don't care how hungry you are.
Thank you.
steel yourselves.
Now, life in this valley can flourish again.
I hope so. Vanaheim has suffered enough.
It will prove resilient.
How are you so sure?
Lands tend to reflect the ones who care for it most.
Was that a compliment?
I heard it too.
Thank you.
Aha! Another fallen piece of Asgard. Something seems a bit different about this one.
Different?
Dunno. I've just a funny feeling.
Your analytical mind knows no bounds.
Hang on a minute. Is this a prison?
It would seem so.
Let's continue. Might be something useful inside. This place goes deep. We should head downward.
Ah, yes. I'm sure there's nothing especially dangerous at the bottom of an Asgardian prison. You're on fire, Fridor!
If the Einherjar survived Ragnarok, perhaps some of the inmates did as well.
Let us find out.
There must be a way to reach the lower levels. Just need to find a way down. That apparatus in the center column. Maybe we could use it. Your spear. You could use it to make a path.
I don't know what the fuck is wrong with this controller, bruh, but this shit don't work, bruh. God damn, how many fucking times I gotta press the down button? God fucking PS4 controllers, man. What the hell, y'all down button don't work?
I do not, sadly. Of course, the Einherjar disappeared a fair few dwarven rebels during the occupation. I suspect this is one of them.
Hmm. Another chain. Shall we find out what this one does?
That's an elf, but not a particularly high-ranking one. So what did Odin have to gain by imprisoning them?
I'd say information, but why keep them locked up afterward? Why not just kill them?
Careful, brother. Prisoners may not be as grateful for their freedom as one would hope. Well, you're very bloody well. little brother. You're covered in Bifrost. Behind you! Incoming!
I don't know. A gardener, perhaps? Dreamshade is difficult to keep alive, even under the best conditions, but this... he gave all the strength to keep it alive.
Then it is right. You should have it.
Odin hid something here. I know it. We should find a way to the cell on the other side.
Freya, I can't believe it.
Wait, that can't be. Lord Tyr.
Is this an illusion?
No, brother. No, I think it's the real deal.
Mimir? Is that you, old friend?
In all the important ways, aye.
There was such a commotion. If Odin learns what you've done...
Odin is dead.
The realms are at last free of him. You're safe.
Odin's dead.
And Asgard fallen.
So the reign of the Aesir is truly over. That's quite a lot to take in. And you are?
His name is Kratos.
Kratos? I know that name.
Come. You need real shelter. Food.
No. No, what I need most now, I think, is to reflect on what you've told me. I need space, if you would grant me that.
Very well. Our home is in the realm between realms for the moment. You can find us there when you're ready.
Kratos. I know you from somewhere. I'm sure it will come back to me.
Until then. You believe that was truly him?
It's hard to trust anything after what we've been through. But with Odin gone, I've no cause to doubt it.
Our paths will cross again. Of that, I'm sure.
Hmm.
Where to now?
Well, now we know what this prison's for. This is where Odin stashed those he would camouflage himself as.
Makes sense. If you're going to imitate someone, you wouldn't want them walking around.
Why not kill them?
He must need them alive in order to assume their form.
Aye. Odin likely wanted Tyr dead for a multitude of reasons. But he knew Tyr would be more useful alive.
Your god of war has truly returned. What now?
He'll want to stretch his legs, I imagine. Imprisonment stokes wanderlust. Not that I need to remind any of us of that. Shame to have left that behind.
You'll be cutting them down like wheat. Oh, heading up already? Got time to check?
Ah, good.
Hello, Rattataska.
Hello, Master Kratos. What you've accomplished for these realms is truly something I never thought possible. Rest assured, good Master Brock would be proud beyond measure, even if only to express it in his love language of profane non-sequiturs. Ah, but he is terribly missed.
Yes, he is.
Now, there is one rather interesting development to apprise you of. The detonation of Asgard shook the world tree to its very roots, dislodging a great number of realm seeds. I thought you might wish to have them. My little way of saying thank you for preventing my death by immolation.
You are welcome. Speak.
The tree has become rather overgrown.
And?
And if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them. Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the Nine Realms, I suppose.
We have seen these stags.
Great! Then all you need is some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Bitterness asked me if I was too chicken to release them. But I am, in fact, not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I have no choice.
Yes,
what a rambunctious bunch.
So, this whole spectral squirrel business. You can shoot out your feelings into little ghosties.
I suppose that is a slightly inelegant way of putting it. These spectral versions of myself are aspects of my personality that I often find distracting at best. My ability not only lets me cast them away and provide some temporary peace of mind, it also allows me to see what goes on outside the tree.
Why not just go look yourself?
As the eternal caretaker of the tree, I may not leave its confines. All part of the deal, but worth it for the immortality and such. My spectral form still allow me to see the outside world, albeit through slightly colorful viewpoints.
That's one word for it. That bitter form of yours is a nasty piece of work.
I'm standing right here, you no-lit freak.
I'd apologize for him, but where would it end? I think that's the long and short of it. Safe travels.
Away with you already!
I am already here, Master Kratos. Perhaps there was some confusion. This is for calling me out here, not for when I am here. Do you just like hearing the sound of the chimes? I suppose they do sound very pretty. Master Kratos, this feels very uncharacteristic of you, but if you enjoy the pretty chimes that much, I will allow you to indulge. Yes, you've done it. Well thrown. Ah, the sound of the chimes is not unpleasant.